Hello viewers, welcome to AP's 5-Minute Ophthalmology Pulse. Watch, understand and remember anything in ophthalmology in under 5 minutes. To understand the anatomical basis of visual field effects in glaucoma, the retina has 10 layers. If these represent the 10 layers of the retina, they are arranged in this manner. For now, we will concern ourselves with the ganglion cell layer and the axons of the ganglion cells that run in the nerve fiber layer. The axons in the nerve fiber layer travel from their place of origin to converge upon the optic disc and leave the eye as the optic nerve. Hence, you would expect that all the nerve fibers would converge in this manner. However, that is not the case. As you can see in this picture, the nasal fibers run a fairly straight course to the optic disc. The fibers from the macula, termed the papillomacular bundle, also follow a straight course to the optic disc. However, the temporal fibers arch over or below the macula to reach the optic disc. The fibers do not cross the horizontal raphe, which divides the temporal retina and therefore the nasal visual field into superior and inferior halves. This anatomical arrangement plays a role in the type of visual field effects that occur in glaucoma. The visual field can be defined as the entire area that can be visualized while looking straight ahead. What is the extent of the visual field? It extends 60 degrees superiorly, 60 degrees nasally, 70 degrees inferiorly, and about 100 degrees temporally. So to recapitulate, 60 degrees superiorly, 60 degrees nasally, 70 degrees inferiorly, and about 100 degrees temporally. The central 30 degree fields are referred to as the central fields. It is here that most of the early changes take place. The point at the center is the fixation point and corresponds to the macula. This is the blind spot. It is a physiological scotoma. A scotoma is an area of reduced or absent sensitivity in the visual field. The blind spot exists because it corresponds anatomically to the optic disc, which does not contain photoreceptors, and so rays of light that fall on this area are not processed and the corresponding objects are not visualized. The blind spot is situated about 15 degrees temporal to fixation. An arcuate region that extends above and below the blind spot to between 10 and 25 degrees of fixation is termed the Behrens area. It is here that most of the early glaucomatous field effects occur because the superotemporal and inferotemporal poles of the optic disc are most susceptible to early damage. The earliest visual field effects are isolated paracentral scotomas. These may be in the superior or inferior field. All the other field effects are believed to be due to enlargement and coalescing of these scotomas. A sidereal scotoma is a sickle-shaped extension of the blind spot. It can occur either superiorly or inferiorly. An arcuate or Behrens scotoma extends from the blind spot, arches above or below fixation, widening as it does so, to reach the median raphe. This is because of the involvement of nerve fiber bundles in the temporal retina. Also, glaucomatous field effects never cross the horizontal raphe. The anatomical basis for both these points was already discussed. If both superior and inferior arcuate scotomas are present, it is termed as a double arcuate or ring scotoma. A nasal step is an area of depression above or below the horizontal meridian on the nasal side. This may occur in the central or peripheral fields, in isolation or in conjunction with other scotomas. It is always present at the nasal meeting point of superior and inferior arcuate scotomas. A temporal wedge may sometimes be present. Bearing of the blind spot is a non-specific defect. It occurs due to exclusion of the blind spot from the contracting central field. Further progression results in loss of most of the fields, except for a central and temporal island of vision due to relative preservation of the papillomacular bundle and some nasal fibers. This central island of vision is referred to as tunnel vision. With further progression, the central island may further reduce in area till finally it is extinguished. A temporal island of vision may be present for a long time before finally it too is lost, resulting in complete blindness. Finally, no discussion on visual fields is complete without acknowledging the humongous work done by two ophthalmologists, one, Dr. Janik Peterson Bierum, who reintroduced and popularized campimetry with a landmark paper in 1889. Campimetry is visual field testing with a tangent screen, which was first introduced by von Griffey. Bierum's name is associated with the tangent screen, Bierum's area, and scotoma, which we have just discussed. And two, Bierum's assistant, Dr. Henning Ronne, who along with Bierum was able to demonstrate the characteristics of the earliest field loss in glaucoma. So that's it for now. If you like what you saw, please give this video a like, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from AP's 5-Minute Ophthalmology Pulse. Please leave a note in the comment section if you wish for any particular topic to be covered in future. Look forward to weekly updates. Thank you for watching.